A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 16th October, on the front page you have India's share of river water will no more go to Pakistan, says Modi. So this is a statement which has been made earlier too, and again at the time of elections, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has made this statement. It actually means that under Indus Water Treaty, there is river water sharing agreement. So under means Indus and the five tributaries, they have been divided between India and Pakistan. So how much water India gets and how much water Pakistan gets. So the thing is that India is an upper riparian state, means Indus, which rises, which is starts from Mansarovar Lake in Tibet, it flows through India and then enters Pakistan and then drains out, and all its tributaries also drain out into Arabian Sea. So from India, the water is going to Pakistan. So whatever is the share of India, if it's not using it, of course, then it will, from upper riparian state, it will drain down to the lower riparian state, Pakistan. So what the Prime Minister is trying to say is that we should use as much water we can. So you can't stop all the flow of the river, or you can't do that. But then it means you have hydroelectric projects, you have infrastructure in place. If you are using that, then you know we will be using it for our country. So it is the government which has to work on it, which has to provide for the dams or hydroelectric projects and for irrigation purposes. So that's what it is. So this is just an emotional statement being made that we know this water will no more go to Pakistan. So if government does it work right, then we'll get all our share. There's no other way that you can stop the river. Then this is IMF trims growth rate to 6.1% in 2019. So World Bank International Monetary Fund annual meeting took place, and here IMF has downgraded global growth in 2019 to 3%, and also India's growth projection has been downgraded from 7% to 6.1% for 2019 as well as 2020. And this is regarding Jammu and Kashmir leader Farooq Abdullah. His sister and daughter have been jailed. So police break up protest in Srinagar. On page 9 you have government to probe irregularities in MP Swachh survey. So this is regarding Swachh Sarvekshan, the survey which takes place for Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. So the Swachh Sarvekshan, which took place in 2019 in Madhya Pradesh, actually a complainant has said that data here has been fudged. Performance of urban local bodies have been overestimated. So actually Madhya Pradesh is the fourth best performing state overall, according to Swachh Sarvekshan 2019. It's the best performing state in solid waste management. And Indore is the cleanest city. Bhopal is the cleanest state capital. Ujjain is the cleanest medium city. You know, Devas is the best small city in innovation and best practices. So Madhya Pradesh has 20 cities among the 100 best performing cities and 8 cities in the top 25. So now there is an investigation which will take place in irregularities here and the complaint which has been made. Then below you have Gujarat, Tamil Nadu top performance under Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana Health Scheme. So Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, Chhattisgarh, Kerala and Andhra Pradesh have emerged as top performing states with free secondary and tertiary treatment worth nearly 7,901 crore availed under the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana or the Ayushman Bharat scheme, the flagship health assurance scheme of the government. So this is there. You see, more than 60% of the amount has been spent on tertiary care. On the editorial page, the first editorial is another grim reminder. So this is regarding the front page news regarding sharp cuts in growth forecast by International Monetary Fund and World Bank. So this underlines slowdown severity as such for India too. And below you have get back to talks. So this is regarding how Telangana should have handled the transport workers strike more sensitively. So the strike which is going on in Telangana, it has reached its 11th day. So talks broke down with the government. So now they have to come back to the table is what the editorial is saying. And the lead article, lynching, the scourge of New India. So this is in the context that RSS chief said that word lynching is of foreign origin. But then this article says that this does not mean that mob killings are alien to India. The issue is covered up in detail here. And this is cost-effective way to power generation. So this is regarding creating generation assets with the lowest unit cost is linked to optimizing plant capacities and using private investment. So we need power generation. We need power generated in the country, but in an cost effective way. So what for that, what should we do is we should create assets, power generation assets. So the assets with lowest unit cost should be created, and this is linked to optimizing plant capacities. So plants which have been set up, their use should be optimized, and private investment should be roped in. So that is argued for in this article. Then this is for a wider food menu. So this says dependence on a few crops has negative consequences for ecosystem and health. So you know, a wider food menu is what has been endorsed here. Rashtriya Poshan Mah, as the central government has also put forth, is it has urged governments, urged people to support the government's nutrition campaign to ensure a healthier future for women and children. On page 12, you have, will confer Bharat Ratna on Savarkar. So this is what BJP party's manifesto for Maharashtra says. It also promises to make the state drought free by 2022. On international page, you have, Russia moves to fill void left by US withdrawal in northern Syria. So Russia says its troops are patrolling territory between Syria and Turkish forces. So this is continuation in the story. US withdrew from northern Syria and Turkey invaded the region, and now the former US allies, you know, the Kurdish force as such, Syrian Democratic Force as it is called, they were supporting US, but now since US abandoned them, they have approached Bashar al-Assad government and the Russian ally, and Russia has moved in to fill the void now. And this is, will not honor UN deal on accountability. So this is Sri Lanka's presidential candidate, Gotabaya Rajapakse. He said that if elected, he would not honor the country's commitments to the UN Human Rights Council on post-war accountability and reconciliation. So this is what the statement has been given us. So he says, we always work with the UN, but I can't recognize what they have signed with the past government. So this is what UN signed with the government earlier. So he says he will not honor that. And here you have Booker Prize winners announced, Atwood and Evaristo. So first time two writers, I will share the award. On business page, you have Jio Bharti Spar again on IUC. So IUC stands for Interconnection Usage Charges. So you should understand what is IUC. It is levied by an operator for completing incoming calls from another network. So TRAI actually had said that IUC should be brought down to zero, and it will be done from 1st Jan 2020. But now TRAI has decided to review this date. It is seeing whether this date can be delayed. So basically, interconnection usage charges benefit the incumbents, means those who have been there in the sector for long, because they have more people using their connections. So it is against the newer entries in the sector, like Reliance Jio would be having to pay these interconnection usage charges initially to those who are incumbents like Airtel, etc. So because of this decision of TRAI to delay scrapping of this charge, again war of words have emerged between Bharti Airtel and Reliance Jio. Then below you have, India's exports declined 6.57% in September. So trade deficit of India is at 7-month low, but India's exports have also remained in the negative zone for the second consecutive month in September. They've contracted. So they've contracted by 6.57%. There's no growth in exports, but contraction in exports. Import too has declined, it is said, by 13.85%. That is it. Then the last page has no news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.